I'm the best ever. There's never been anybody ruthless. I'm Sonny Liston. I'm Jack Dempsey. There's no one like me. I'm from Nairclough. There's no one that can match me.
Okay, I'm at the press conference for the moment of truth. Just before that press conference, we had the James Degale press conference where he announced his next opponent will be Marco Antonio Pereira. Manager to James Degale, Ambrose, frustration there on that table, it sounds like to yourself.
Yeah, frustration is probably the right word. Yeah, you kind of suck things up, and then you get to a point where it all appears to be a nonsense. And here we have, you know, we're here today to announce the fact that James Degale, MBE, Olympic gold medalist, former British European WBC silver champion, is being kept at bay quite deliberately by somebody who holds himself out to be a legendary fighter. And I think that's all wrong. But you know, my CV says I found a wonderful way of making right wrongs, particularly within the world of sport, and that's what I have to do here. But do I protest on behalf of James? Absolutely. James Degale is the number one 168 guy in the world, and the route that we chose to go was the IBF, and James was a mandatory. We all know what happened at Wembley. Was outstanding, unbelievable. And the frustration comes in. Here we are, 4.5 months later, and James is having to take an interim fight so that he keeps himself in the correct physical and mental space. And that's what we're going to do. However, the message that I deliver to Froch is, you know, man up, do the decent thing. You've had a great career. Retire on the basis of that great CV. Or fight James, get in the ring. He's guaranteed £4 million. But how do you turn that down? This is the second highest payday of his career. So, and he's, you know, standard rent is that, you know, it's not a fight that anyone wants to see. That's not for him to judge. It's what's been ordered. It's been mandated. James is not an attraction. What an idiot. And what a stupid thing to say. He's not an attraction. It will sell the other two out in an hour. In fact, maybe in 30 minutes. As I say, he's guaranteed millions and millions of pounds to fight. He's got to do it.
Why do you think you've stolen from Carl Froch and his team? Is it a case of, as James Degale says, his style just causes too much problems for Froch, or is he looking for a bigger fight in the States, as he
says? There is no bigger fight in the States. Just get clear on that. There is no bigger fight. He could go and fight Andre Ward. He's running scared of fighting Andre Ward. Ward probably wants a great money, he should do. So that's not going to happen. Chavez, please. You know, some people need to wake up. Mm. Go and have a look at the guy. The guy is as fat as a stuck pig. Mm. You know, enjoying himself, and quite rightly. The world comes to him. But if Chavez was to come over here, wouldn't take off, wouldn't ignite. Mm. If you look at him, is he an undefeated fighter? No. Those of a certain age know that his father was an absolute icon. But he isn't his father. But most importantly, he has no intention of being prepared and ready to fight Carl Froch anytime soon, and certainly not within the restrictions laid down by the International Boxing Federation. So for Froch, it's very simple. You fight James Degale, or you give the belt up, or be stripped. And the indignity of that is not something I think he would want to stomach. Do I think that Carl Froch will come and fight James Degale? No, I don't. You ask me the question, no. So what we've chosen to do is to put James in front of somebody who's hugely experienced and who is coming to win, and coming through that fight, and then early next year fighting for the vacant title.
With all the stalling, was it always the intentions to have, as you say, an interim fight in between, the possibility of having a Carl Froch fight? Was that always the intention?
Well, because since the May 31st day, both fighters, the champion and the mandated challenger, being promoted by the same promoter, could have sat at a table and agreed to fight at any time. Did we seriously think that James was going to have to wait until the beginning of next year to go straight into a world title fight? No. And that's the reason why Marco Antonio Pereira has been selected for, you know, James' next fight.
It seems from the outside looking in that initially when they were talking about James Degale fighting Carl Froch, a lot of the public said it isn't going to happen. Carl Froch isn't going to fight James Degale. Then it seemed to be where it got a lot closer that it could happen when they were both, I think, on Sky Sports together.
Yeah.
Now it seems kind of further away again. Is that what the frustrations are, where it seems to be close and far away, then close and far away?
All of this, don't blame the matchroom, don't blame Eddie Hearn, blame Carl Froch. Just blame Carl Froch, who has turned into a dictator. You know, it will be my rules the way I want it. Well, he's within the guidelines at the present moment. But listen, if I'm a fighter, and please do me some credit, I know a little bit about steering and managing a fighter. People talk about Nigel Benn, 25 years on from his feats, they grow bigger and bigger by the day, and people seek to emulate it. It didn't just happen overnight. You know, we were two kids from the East End of London, 10 years age difference, similar family backgrounds, you know, second generation immigrants here. We're talking about two guys now. One is he's of Polish heritage. The other one is of African Caribbean heritage. And so it should be quite simple, because they aspire to earn great sums of money. Millions and millions is on offer here to Carl Froch. He's not interested. So James's attitude is simple. I don't care who the champion is. That's the person that's standing in the way of me making history by becoming the first British Olympic gold medalist boxer to become world professional champion. Never been done. Ever, ever been done. That's tremendous, tremendous aim. Mm. And to do that, it looks like James will have to fight the Mexican Ramirez, who is 23 years of age, 6'2", has had 29 fights, 29 wins, and 24 KOs.
Tough.
Is James losing any sleep? The answer is no. If he is the person they say I've got to fight, I'm fighting him.
I asked James earlier, and he kind of, I'd like to see what your take is. Is the lure to fight Carl Froch, is the lure to fight for a world title?
The lure is to fight for a world title.
Mm.
End of.
Okay. Gut feeling, will it happen?
No.
And if it doesn't happen, it's simply going to come for it.
Who cares?
Yeah.
You know, it's transitional. You know, the king is dead, long live the king. That's what people care about.
Mm.
You know, we're not in the dark ages where, you know, the colour of your skin said you're not going to get this, that and the other, etc., etc. The ethos that our fathers installed into us, you've got to work twice as hard. We got used to working twice as hard, now it's normal. Now it's normal. Hey, and you've got a guy who's twice as hard working, ready now to fight anybody. He has the best one-on-one trainer in boxing, Jim McDonald, former European super featherweight champion. Of course, a guy who ended the career of Barry McGuigan, twice fought for a world title. I think I know what I'm doing.
Mm.
You know, my personal belief is that Matchroom are the best promoters. Eddie Hearn and I and his dad and I have great conversations. That is how it is. You can't say it better than that. We're a team ready to go places and go and do damage.
Yeah. Off subject, very quickly, Chris Eubank Jr., Billy Joe Saunders. Obviously, you were around with the Nigel Benny, Chris Eubank. You're an integral part of that. Who do you think wins that fight?
Well, it goes further than that, because at the behest of his father, I turned Chris Eubank Jr. professional.
Oh, okay.
Working with his dad, took him to Hennessy Sports, and in fact drew up the contract. Chris and I, contrary to what people might believe, are good time buddies. You know, with regards to Christopher Jr., he set himself a monster task. He's fighting against a guy who is a British, European and Commonwealth champion, former Olympic medalist, a bronze medalist, and who has in his corner and throughout his entire career the bemedaled trainer Jimmy Tibbs, and they're going on a one-on-one mission here. In Eubank's corner is the austerity of his dad. He has a wonderful trainer, Ronnie Davis, and he's got family support around him. They're all boxing centric. His dad, who abhors boxing, said it from the outset, you know, it's something he had no intention of remaining with, suddenly changed his mind.
Mm.
So whoever does their homework best is going to emerge victorious.
Okay. Okay, there you go. There's Mr. Ambrose giving his opinions on the Carl Froch, James Degale situation, obviously, and giving his opinions on Christy Britton, Julia Villegas Saunders. Thanks a lot, Mr. Ambrose.
Pleasure.